Ben also here. How you position? Right.
Flywheel and crankshaft support.
We are putting and the top main bearing. It's the same thing we are doing. Ready?
Yeah.
And now we will install the crankshaft. We'll put oil also. We have to put the thrust washers. This one.
First washer.
Yes. You can put it easy from here because exists the location. Press the crankshaft like that. Already driver inside. Finish. How's it? Yes, installing the caps. Bring me one plastic hammer. Where is the socket? Bring the okay. Thank you. just tidying. David, please continue. Sorry, let me start typing. Right, everything just tidy. Not too strong, we have to use upper door paints. The step that this particular engine require is 61 Newton-meter, first step. Second step, you have to tighten all the bolts 90 degrees. So we will show you how we can do it easily without mirometer. Practically every time. But we are very close from the instructions that the repair manual used to give us. David, who asked you to try the thing so strong? Give me 20, how much is this one? 22.
22 sockets.
Actually, it's supposed to move. Three.
He's ready, yeah, he's ready.
We are tidying 61 Newton-meter, first step, all the bolts. Let's do it. Pass everything and we make one retest. Second step, give me the tippex. Second step, now, this is the front side, the pulley side of the crankshaft, the front side, the flywheel side. We will put marks like this. Leave it to dry and we will tie 90 degrees. We are tying 90 degrees. You are ready? From this location that used to be before, you tie it 90 degrees so you know how approximately we are. This is the second step. This is what we expect to see. We tie it 90 degrees. And now we are making test to see if the crankshaft is turning free. We don't want to apply too much power. It's okay. It's turning. So this is it. How we are putting the main metal bearing on the engine.
Okay, so this is the kit for the gasket overhaul. The original from Toyota. That's the part number for the gasket timing chain. And then the part number for the gasket kit.
So now, this is the bolts that go by side. Here. We want to change the seals. Inside to the set exists original seals. This one is new. This is the new seals that we want to put. We are putting the seals for the bolts. This special washers with a rubber with an O-ring seal attachment to cover the leakage from the side of the block cylinder. So now, as we have, put one more. Save it, go from this side. Take, go from this side. We are putting the short one coming here. The long one is behind the flywheel sides. Please bring me one 16, I think, or 15. Great. This one here. Thank you. Now, David, tied with your pants, everything. Again, again. For one more time, we use torque wrench. I think it's 54 newton meter. Yeah, 52 newton meter. We put. Now, we tight 52 newton meter the side box. This is the top ring. Second ring. And here is the oiling ring. It's three pieces. It's the first rail, second rail, and the middle is the groove. How you call this?
Groove.
Groove. Uh-huh. Yes. Grover. So now, inside we clean it already. That I'm going to show. We have here the original set, as we say. This one is from the oil side, eh? Oh, yes.
Yes.
Yes. So, it's like that. Top, second, rings. Oil rings. We are doing as it is. We are collecting the oil one. We are putting it. Actually, exists special tool that we can remove. But in our case, we don't have it available. We are doing it manually, carefully. It's very sensitive. You can break it anytime. Don't forget to enter now, imagine. It's not a great to enter now. Services, the rails from the pistons. The same thing we are doing for all pistons. Now we take carburetor cleaner. Or anything, or we can use air. Yes. Clean.
Yeah.
try to make the assembly. This one is new.
Yes, you see the other one. I don't know how it is.
Complete the downside. Now we are putting the secondary at special location. Have one gap here. This side supposed to be downside like this. We show also manual photo. Let's go to show exactly how we are. The second ring, this is the gap. Here is the gap and the oil ring. The second ring, I'm talking, yes. And now the last one. The last one, this particular one don't have any sign. You can put it anyhow.
Yeah, hold on, let me focus.
So we are putting it. And this is it. Finish. With the same way, we will work the remaining pistons. Now, as it is, we have changed already the bearing also on the connecting rod. Here, the standard dimension have. So, as we say, now second step. We need to locate the correct location, the rings, the piston rings. So I put already the marks and I will show after what this means. Actually here is the gap that the middle side, the spring, let's say that it's coming here. The down rail is coming here and the up is coming opposite from here. Or you can change it opposite. Second ring, the second one that is this side. Like this, the second one is coming here and the first one is coming here. This is the way that Toyota requests to put. So now let's see it on the repair manual also how it is. It's showing us here oil ring, expander, middle, side rail from the oil spring. Going one side, opposite is going the other. Second ring, the gap is coming here, and the first ring, the gap is coming here. This is the correct location to have good correct compressor and the oil rings to seal correct the cylinder. Here. I don't like how this thing is inside. This is the gap from the rail. One in the middle is the gap from the oil, and somewhere here supposed to be the other one. Here. This one is here, and this one we put it here. So now we take the special tool to keep it, to press the rings. Very carefully, to don't approximately, to don't relocate too much. And we tighten the springs. Great. Also, something very important, oil. You put oil. Simon, please help me keep it. Now we are tightening it final, totally. And now, as it is, we have to set the thing to be straight. Simon, one more time, I want to try. It's a matter of settings now to have succeed. Yes. So now the direction is going like that. This mark here is supposed to look front of the pulley side. This is bank 2. We are putting the fourth cylinder. We already replace the metal bearing. Inside here we have to be carefully to don't wound the nozzle. So accept that, please. We have to put oil into the cylinder. The lubrication is very important. This now we are taking, we are putting, we are setting it small. We are taking hammer. We want to set it correct for this reason. We are going smoothly. This is it. For safety reason, because actually this special tool is not the professional one. Well, it's not good. We are going very side. Now we want to tie it. Under, please, Simon. Wait, just bend it. Want to locate it correct.
You turn it upside down completely.
Eh? Now we are driving. Like this. Now Simon help me to
turn it back.
Keep it like that. Exactly. Now we want to show better. Going like this, the metal bearing is here. We are using the down. You have to be very careful. This also requires torque range tightening, but approximately we just tight to be steady on the crankshaft. This is the way how you put piston and connecting rod inside to the cylinder and connect with the crankshaft.